I'd say if you compare cars formed to last year, I'd say the big difference is just his scrambling around the green would be his biggest difference. It's a lot better this year. So first hole, it's you could use driver if you're a crazy guy, but using driver brings fescue into play. So most of the players will just hit a driving iron on the first. Plus the first is also into the wind this morning, so you don't want to hit the big dog straight up. So let's have a look down the first hole here. We're looking into the sun, nothing I can do about that. You can see how the fairway bottlenecks.
Second fence, north and south amateur. This is the 8 a.m. starting time. First on the tee, from Australia, please welcome Carl Phillips.
Rapturous applause from the gallery. Got the wind hitting the back of the mic, so sorry about that. Right, driving iron in the first hole. I think I saw something bouncing up the fairway there. Well, so Carl's used driving iron so as to take this bottleneck out of play, but as you'll see behind him, he's actually in the bottleneck of this fairway, so you might want to review which club he hits off the tee in the next round, because that club hasn't taken danger out of play, and he's almost did it. Nevertheless, you take your blessings as they come. So now he's in a good position to throw this short iron, about 10 feet short of this flag. If he's 20 feet short, the ball's going to feed back down the front of the green. These greens were sanded last week, so they're not as fast as they usually would be, and so they shouldn't likely have as much bounce as they normally would have. Sorry, someone's just lit up a cigarette upwind from me without realising that I'm downwind. Lucky we're not in California. That's a nice high finish. Get that ball landing soft. It's coming in a little bit low, so he's going to hit a couple of times and then come to a screeching stop. You see how soft that green is? During the north and south year last year, that would have bounded. So they're a lot softer than they were last year. Carl Stanford bag. This is actually last year's bag. This year's bag is the bag they used in 21-22 is black. Alright, Carl with two putts from, I guess, 25 feet. He would have been expecting from past years to see that ball bounce a couple of times and then settle down, and it's just stopped where it landed. So he's got a little bit more distance here, I'd say 25 feet here. He's got a little bit more, probably 15 feet more than what he was expecting. I've been expecting to be putting from around that 10 to 15 foot range from where he was. About 3 or 4 feet past. And kind of tidy up here for his part. Okay. Well, par's always a good start in this opening hole. I mean, yes, you'd like a birdie, but you know, you get some of the nerves out of the way. Second hole around 430 odd yards. Very overcast this morning. Into the wind, coming off the left. Really good balance. Looking at it intently. Right, Carl missed the fairway with his driver. I'm up behind the green, so he's missed it right. But if you're not behind the fescue, the lies on the sand are generally very good. So I can't see it representing any problem. What he will need to do, due to the greens being softer, however, it's just be aware how much his ball's going to rip when it lands, because it's going to spin back if he's not careful, and he can't really go past this flag because his ball will feed off irrespective of how much spin it's got on it. Here's the back of the green here, just falls off to the right, and he's got to go up a bit with a half a club and just take some speed off here. Takes some spin off. It's very difficult to get up and down from behind the screen here, so better to err on the side of being short of the flag from where he is rather than taking the flag on. His reaction is fairly good. Oh, that's a great shot for where he was. So he's obviously gone up the club and just taken a bit off it there, which is really good golf. Right, Carl with about 10 to 12 feet for his birdie. Be nice to get off to a good start. There we go. Good birdie. Third hole. Balance, really nice balance, looking straight into the sun. So I think he's missed the fairway there. I'm up near next to the green and Carl's missed this fairway as well, so he's playing catch up, and with that with a 4-iron off the tee, he shouldn't be missing that fairway. From the fairway. Oh, good shot. 6 feet. Great shot from where he was. Just being a smart aleck now. I'm kind of hoping for a birdie, but this one may look like it breaks, but actually I don't think it does. It's just the aspect of the green from where the players are putting from can be very confusing. When Donald Ploss and subsequently Gil Hartz renovated this, they knew what they were doing. Oh, got it. Well done. Two under, 3-3. Some of you might be asking, geez, he's missed three of the first four fairways. Well, the northeast finished on Saturday. We didn't get here until yesterday afternoon, till Sunday afternoon. And Carl was just absolutely zonked because he had to sleep in the airport on Saturday night because our flight was boarding at 4:30 in the morning. It was pointless paying an exorbitant price for a hotel just for a few hours sleep. So gave them the day off on Sunday. They're playing two courses here, so they need to practice both courses. And so he decided just to have one practice day, but four or five holes into his practice round, they got rained out for the day. So he's played literally four or five practice holes, but he knows his courses like the back of his hand. So, but he just hasn't had enough range time between tournaments here, so that's why he's a little bit rough off of the tee. But the rest of his game's looking good. It's a closed face. Oh, right over the flag. How neat is that? Now, he had this exact same putt last year. Exact same putt. Either last year or in 2019. Let's see if he can remember the break. In previous years, this putt would have been batting to stop by the time it got to the hole. But this year, because they sanded these greens just a week ago, they're a lot slower than normal. So, looking at just a hint of right to left. Just a hint. I wouldn't give the hole away. I'll keep it inside the right leg. Gave the hole away. Right, we're just about ready to go here on the par 5 fifth. 2 under 3-4, missed an absolute doily on the last hole. Just read something into the putt that wasn't there. Sometimes, PGA players do it as well, sometimes when a putt looks dead straight, they imagine that there must be something there when there's not. There's nothing there, there's nothing there. Let's see if we can get Carl's ball flight here. Use ball tracking. So, Carl's actually hit the fairway off of the tee here. Don't know what's going on. But 228 out would likely be a 6-iron. Because he'll be drawing this in with a hint of wind assist. His body reaction will tell us what we need to know, and then I'll pen onto the green, because I'm up halfway between Carl and the green. Seems okay with it. Let's see what the deal is. And he's followed his playing partner Zach in falling off the right side of the green there. Just got a bit too aggressive with that. So pretty much want to go straight at that flag, and if it ends up right on the flag, great, it's a bonus. But if not, you're faced with exactly the scenario that he's got here. So got to get it up over this ridge. Good speed. And eagle. There you go. Takes him to 4 under. Well done. And good option to putt it there, guys. Started way right, so it's never going to draw enough to get back on the line that he needed. Even though it's not Carl's putt, he's going to putt first to speed up play here, because his playing partner got into a spot of bother. About 25-30 feet. See if we can track it into the hole, shall we? Here's the hole. Always hang on to your yardage books from year to year. Unless they reshape the greens, they're gold. Par 4 7th. Starting line's critical here. Car's got to keep it to the left of the bunkers and occupy the landing area to the right, where his ball should finish. The green should have room today. It's going to be a little baby cut starting up the left. Not quite sure where it's gone. It's a very technical bit of teamwork that they've got there, where Erica very discreetly shrugs her shoulders, which I'm guessing means haven't got a clue. Carl hit the fairway. In previous incarnations he's hit the fairway, but he's also been in this bunker here, and he's tried laying up on this hole and it didn't work. Over the years he's learnt the best way to play this hole is driver off the tee to here. Gives you a very short iron into a very tough green. If you go past this flag, you'll go off the green. So starting to hit fairways now as he's getting into the round. Just wasn't feeling his mojo. I think the biorhythms were a bit out earlier this morning. It's a weird swing. How's it going there? Yeah, it's putting for birdie. And he didn't go past the flag, that was the key there. Just don't entertain going past that flag, it's a trap. just missed it low side, and it goes off for a bit of a run on its own accord. So with that putt coming back there, it's not going to break as much as it did going past, because the player's going to be hitting the putt firmer than what it did in the period between where it stopped and where it went past the hole. So that putt coming back should be inside our right edge of the cup, firm. So this is one of those tricky ones. If you hit it soft, it will break a ton. But if you hit it firmly, it will only move an inch or so. So firmly inside Carl's left lip, which is our right side of the hole. Could have hit it a bit firmer than that to take some of that break out. I think when you're putting uphill, guys, firm is fine. But it's a par. Yep, it's on the fairway. Alrighty. Carl got out driven. Gonna have around a 6-iron into the flag here. Flag is on the right, so suits either shape really, a draw or a cut, doesn't really matter, but being into the wind, I dare say he's gonna play a touch of a draw. Hard to judge the wind when you're down in the valley there, but it's now switched around a bit to be coming just straight off its left. So be around the side of caution and just trying to keep this about 10 feet left of the flag, so you're towards the heart of the green. Don't want to have a missed green if you can avoid it. He's buddy. A couple of feet off the green. Say 3 feet off. See if he can do what he did on the par five and put it in from off of the green. Inches to clean up here. So he remains at 4 under through 8 holes, 1 shot off the lead. Par 3, 8th. Wind's dropped momentarily, so let's take advantage of it. Pins on the left deer. I wouldn't be waiting around sun, I'd be hitting before the wind comes back, because it was 5 to 10 miles an hour just a minute ago. Not here for a magazine spread. Come on, let's get going. Here comes the wind again, slightly into him. Just feeling it on my back. He's trying to do something that's not quite normal because he never uses a tee normally. Okay, Carl's decided that he wants to play in the sand. He's had this identical shot at the US amateur quarterfinal match that he was in 2019. Identical. He's got to land this quick. Because the ball will feed past the hole unless he lands this quickly. He's played it well. Yeah, well done. Really well done. Good Sandy. So that's 4 under through the first 9.